I have what I believe to be the silliest line of Java code ever written. Welcome to Tales from the Jar Side. Now, I know that's a bold claim, and bold claims require bold evidence. I'm going to use two features from modern Java. I'm going to use Java records. Not terribly silly at all, actually, and local variable type inference, which is quite silly. And that's going to be the heart of it.
I have a silly
line of Java code.
And I'd like to obtain a government grant to help me develop it.
I've got a project here, and I have a package called Var. Now, Var is the heart of local variable type inference, but it's not a keyword. It's a reserve type name. That's important because it means I can use it all over the place, even if I'm not using it for local variable type inference. Let me add a record to that package. I'll add a record named var with a capital V. Unfortunately, I can't make one named var with a lowercase v. But what I can do is I can also make a property of the record called var as well. I can't use var for a property at all. If I try to do that, I get an error immediately. It says unknown class var. It thinks it's a class. It's not going to let me do it. All right, I'll stick with that string. And now we are off to the races because it's bad enough that I've got a package name var and a property name var and incidentally a getter method named var with parentheses. That's what records do. When you access a property of a record, the form of the getter is the property itself with parentheses on it. But now I have a record name var. Okay, let's actually make a test class. But here I'm going to put the test class in a completely different package because with this package, I actually want to import var as well. What I've done is I've made a package called silly because why not? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a test here called var test. Let me add a test. And here is my first attempt at really being very silly. So what you can see is that I have a test also called var because why not? I have var for the local variable type inference. I have a variable name var, and here I've instantiated my var class with the argument var is a string, and this all is fine, and I can put in my assertion as well. My assertion is an equality check so that using the getter method var, remember the name of the method matches the name of the property with parentheses in it, var.var will return var. I think that's pretty silly. You may disagree, but I think that's pretty good. But it occurs to me, I can actually make it even sillier.
It's not particularly silly, is it?
Yes, I think with government backing, I could make it very silly.
What I'm doing now is I went back to the var record, and it occurs to me I can add a static factory method that will allow me to get rid of that word new. So let me add that as well. The static factory method I've added is also called var. I will use it to instantiate an instance of this class with that argument. Now with this thing in place, I can go back to my test and get rid of that word new. You see what I have achieved here is the following ridiculous line, var var equals var dot var of var. And the test still passes. Everything is perfectly fine, accessing the variable and everything. I think that's pretty darn silly. I think that's about as ridiculous as you can make it. Now, the other subtle point here is I had to import the var class because, of course, it is in a different package. It's in the var package. I could, in principle, replace this var with var.var, and that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vars in the same line. The only problem with that is now I'm not using local variable type inference at all. Now I've got an actual type, var.var of var equals var.var of var. So if I go back to the other way, what I was hoping to do was to get rid of the import and instead qualify the class with var.var using the package name. And it does understand that I don't need the import anymore, but now this is not working. It says variable var might not have been initialized. In other words, it doesn't get it that it's a package in this particular case. It's confused. Maybe that's an IDE thing. I'll go into Gradle and I'll see if I could run the test. And no, it's Java going, cannot infer the type of the local variable var, cannot use var on a self-referencing variable. I did hit the limit before. Let me put my import statement back in. And I think that is about the limit of the amount of silliness I can achieve with this app. If you can think of anything else I can do with this, anything even sillier, then please let me know in the comments. But I think I've achieved maximum silliness this way, both with the one-liner here and even with the removing the import and referencing var as var.var instead. What have we accomplished? What I've mostly accomplished is job security, because if this comes up on a code review, it's likely to make some people quite insane. They're not going to be happy. I imagine they will comment on it. And of course, if I manage to get this code into production somewhere, they will hunt me down. Nobody will want to maintain that code. But still, as an illustration of what you can do with LVTI, there you go. I hope you enjoyed that. What I would normally say now is like, comment, share, and subscribe, and you'll see the subscribe buttons popping up. But the truth is, what I really need on my channel the most right now is watch hours, and hey, you're still here. Thanks. You did it for me. Thank you very much. See you next time on Tales from the Jar Side.